human curiosity has definitely gone to some great lengths, bringing us to the stage of evolution we experience today. However, there are so many truths that we are never to figure out. Surprisingly enough, there are even processes in our own bodies that we don't realize. Or, I'd rather say, our conscious mind doesn't realize.
In this documentary, I'll meet you with Danny and Christo. Both were led by the need to make a radical change in order to overcome internal problems which had violently begun to come out. I'll also speak to a hypnotherapist who helps people that have struggled to cope with their problems through conventional medicine alone. A hypnotist and magician will introduce you to the behind the curtains of hypnosis. As a final, I, myself, will undertake a hypnotherapy session and put you right there in the action. Of relaxation.
While evolving, we have developed the unique ability to do everything possible, both consciously and subconsciously, in order to maintain the stable condition of our organisms. Every time our bodies face something extraordinary, this trigger or stressor evokes a specific response, such as an increase in the cardiovascular activity or the secretion of a specific hormone.
Actually, even the thought that you're about to do some exercise, for example, makes your body enter a specific mode. Major adjustments in your physiology get you ready for the physical exertion before it's even begun. It turns out that whenever a stressor arises, you can notice a change in your cardiovascular activity. This way you get the increased oxygen and blood flow in your muscles needed for performing the exercise. However, a physical activity like this is usually a positive experience. What happens if the stressor is a negative one? What happens to your body when you go through some kind of entirely emotional pain or psychological stress?
American study from 2012 yet again proves the link between prolonged stress and failure in the inflammatory response, which means that stress may be responsible for a huge number of health issues ranging from colds to autoimmune diseases and cancer.
Нека разкажа за емоциите. Емоциите, обикновено негативните, са свързани с отделяне на токсини. Ако тези токсини не излизат от тялото, не се изкарват чрез спорт или някакво отпускане, те остават тялото ти и започват да ефектират тялото.
While we usually try to fight health issues through conventional medicine, it's controversial whether it can really treat a psychosomatic problem where the physiological complaints are merely symptoms. Not to mention that due to the long list of side effects of most psychotropic medicines, it becomes doubtful whether they improve or actually worsen the condition.
Реших да изпробвам хипнозата, защото в даден момент се почувствах много зле. Гадаше ми се, виеше ми се свят, не можех да излизам никъде. Първо потърсих медицинска помощ, ходих при всякакви специалисти, предписаха ми купища лекарства, които имаха безброя много странични ефекти, но нищо от това не помогна.
The question is, how do you fight something that happens entirely in your mind? Something that doesn't have a physical explanation because it has its roots solely in your subconscious. That's why there is an increasing number of people who turn to alternative methods such as hypnotherapy. And that's why I met Goran Ivanov, a Bulgarian hypnotherapist who helps people in their battle with themselves.
Значи, моите наблюдения за повечето психически и физически разстройства са на обикновено натрупан стрес, преживяни много негативни емоции, които обикновено или сбиват някакво психологически проблем като депресия, като тревожност, безсъние или като физиологическа болест, като рак или някаква друга болест. Терапия, моя метод е насочен към бъдещето, търсене на идеалния резултат и чрез внушения постигане този идеален резултат, който се стремат хората. Примерно да се чувстват в някаква ситуация спокойни, когато сред хора спокойни или да нямат негативни мисли. Просто не се стремя да открия защо са тези негативни мисли, а просто правя така, препрограмира мозъка, че той да почне да мисли позитивни неща.
Suggestion is a dominant idea given by the hypnotherapist in the trance-like state of hypnosis as a direct command. Once embedded in a person's
mind, it changes their attitude and goals. And many recent studies have shown that there is no difference between conscious and unconscious goals in terms of their outcomes. Thus, a person's behavior and thoughts are led towards the accomplishment of a certain goal. However, we have to point out that there is no such thing as giving up control under hypnosis. When we say a hypnotic trance, what we actually mean is an altered state of awareness combined with deep relaxation. This makes you more responsive to ideas and pictures. After all, it's all about switching off our too rational conscious mind.
При внушенията използвам думите на хората. Примерно, той иска човек да е спокоен. Аз го питам какво значи да си спокоен. Записвам неговите думи. И после му ги връщам в самата хипноза. Като използвам думите на хората, техния речник, при внушенията, самите внушения са по-силни. Много малко хора не могат да се повлияват от терапията. Понякога е нужно повече време да се повлияват. Понякога е нужно аз да разбера как да ги повлияя. Разликата между по-трудните клиенти е, че отнема повече време.
In order to find out how easy or hard it is to get to someone's subconscious, I turned to Manny, a British hypnotist and magician currently practicing in Sydney, Australia. I asked him about his way to get into someone's mind only minutes after meeting them for the first time.
With theatrical hypnosis, stage hypnosis, you need them to believe in you, you need them to trust you. Once you've built up your authority, I need to portray confidence, 100% confidence. Again, I haven't got half an hour to put them to sleep. I've only literally got about 3-4 minutes at the most. If I take too long while I'm performing, people will get bored. So from the outright, I need to give my first command, suggestion, say to them, put your feet straight together, flat on the floor. That's my command. If I know they listen to me then, I know they're going to listen to me later on. I'm building up my authority. As opposed to me saying, oh, can you please move your foot forward? I have to be like, move your foot forward. I'm giving a straight command on it. Move your foot forward, feet flat on the ground. If I see a bit of doubt there, I have to portray more authority. From now on, every command I give is a suggestion for later on. It shows me that they can listen. That's the main importance. I put them asleep maybe 30 seconds later. If I know they're fully asleep, the first thing I say to them, everything I say and do in the next couple minutes will temporarily become your reality. It only lasts a few minutes, but at the end of it, you're going to laugh at it and you're going to find it hilarious. So what I've done there, I've thrown this suggestion and influence into the subconscious. I've told them what's going to happen. Now if I told them everything I say and do, it will become a reality. Then I think, oh my God, he's going to influence me for the rest of my life. If I tell them, if I say the word temporarily, then they're going to believe it. The mind's going to process it and it's going to go into the subconscious. Put them to sleep. I told them outright, everything I say and do, I'm going to be talking to your subconscious mind. I'm telling them the command, everything I say and do will be directly to your subconscious part of your mind, to the hidden part of your mind. So what that does, that kind of, it's like a kind of a clash in the mind. So you might, their mind is telling them, right, everything I say and do will automatically happen because my subconscious is taking over. So I won't have to think about it, it will just happen. When it comes to their own will, I believe, and other hypnotists believe, that a person won't do anything against their own will. So on a subconscious level, whatever you tell them to do, they kind of want to do in a way, tell them to cluck like a chicken, then they're most likely not going to do it because a part of them doesn't want it to happen. If, however, they want the attention from their surroundings, from the peers, they will follow through with that and they will allow it to happen. I can only do things if you allow them to happen once you're hypnotized. You've got some type of control, so even though the subconscious has taken over, the conscious is there just to block out certain uncomfortable things. If you're not comfortable with it, the person will tell me and they will stop what they're doing.
Let's take a look at the situation from another perspective. What if you're in the hypnotherapist's client shoes? How would you let the hypnotherapist get into the deepest thoughts and emotions?
Имах период, в който се чувствах по-напрегнат от нормалното. Усещането, че имам по-високи нива на стрес и реших да опитам хипноза, хипнотерапия, да видим какъв ще бъде резултатът на ни. Ами, интересувал съм се, гледал съм много филми, винаги им било любопитно. И реших да пробвам. В началото бях доста скептичен до някаква степен. И ми беше трудно първия път да навляза в това състояние. Но след това успях. С всяка следваща сесия ставаше, да кажем, че съм бил 5 или 6 сесии, може повече да са били.
Бях изплашена от това какво се състои самия процес, но също се оказа, че е доста приятен.
Много приятно състояние. Даже съм си го мислил как да го обясна по някой, който ме пита, примерно, на себе си да го обясня. И за мен е това като един вид, понеже аз, нали, това нещо го търсих заради нивата на стреса и напрежението, което човек в дадения момент от живота си му се натрупа преклено много. И примерно масаж, примерно отидеш да си направиш някъде, един класически масаж, той отпускаш, нали? Но това е свързано с тялото. И за мен хипнозата беше нещо като масаж, но на душата или по-скоро или на душата, или на подсъзнанието по някакъв начин.
Самия процес на хипноза беше много интересен за мен. Когато бях в хипноза, някакси се изолирах от страничните шумове и не чувах нищо друго, освен гласа на моя хипнотерапевт. Той ме караше да си визуализирам различни места, като например картини, да ги отдалечавам, приближавам. Караше ми различни внушения. Процесът на събуждане също беше много интересен. Той броеше от 10 към 1, при което с всяка цифра усещах как се чувствам все по-бодра. Накрая се събудих свежа и отпочинала, заредена с нови сили. Симптомите ми напълно бяха отшумяли.
Много приятно, лежерно, но трябва сам да си позволиш да стигнеш до това ниво. И да имаш доверие на и на хипнозата като метод, и на човека, който, с който работиш, който те вкарва в това състояние, хипнотерапевта.
Having heard all of that, I couldn't help but become curious, so I decided to undertake some therapies myself. I decided to turn to him due to a personal problem of mine, trust issues, which I think all of us have. Or do we? Never mind. I'm going to check if that works and I don't know if that's going to work. Not 100% sure, but am I going to try it? Definitely yes.
Now I want to imagine a beautiful place, a calm place, a place that you feel very calm and relaxed. Maybe a place that you was before. Maybe a place that you want to go. Maybe it's in the nature. Maybe it's some other place. But what place you choose, you will feel calm and relaxed there. Everything will calm you and make you relaxed there. Преди да задавам този въпрос, как си представяте, че се случат нещата, ако всичко, което съм направил в терапията е идеално, всичко е станало както искате, как ще чувствате в бъдеще? I'll come from 1 to 3. When I count to 1 to 3, you can allow yourself to relax 3 times deeper. Винаги подхождам индивидуално, защото някои хора по-трудно се отпускат, по-лесно се отпускат. При ни хора, някои методи на директни внушения работят по-добре. Това са обикновено 90% от хората, реагират много добре на директни внушения. Има хора, които не реагират добре на внушения, чрез тях работа чрез други техники. Използвам нервно-лингвистичното програмиране, други методики. Някои хора по-трудно се отпускат, при тях използвам по-различно влияние. Като ангажирам съзнанието, примерно казвам сега, ще си представиш, че си на един плаж, начертай един кръг на този плаш и започни да пишеш числата от 100 до 1. Като започнат те да си представят това нещо и да го правят съзнателно, съзнанието е... съзнанието на хората е ангажирано с нещо и подсъзнанието се отваря към внушение.
You see a road close to the river. Take this road that will guide you to a place of magical water. That you will be drink. And when you drink this water will make you more easy, more calmer, and more confident when you meet the new people. It will make you easy to connect with new people. All the fear that you have before will disappear.
При хипноза използвам внушение и визуализации. Внушенията, които са насочени в подобряване на тяхния начин на живот и обикновено визуализациите, когато се използват в по-отпуснато състояние на хипноза, самия мозък не разбира дали нещо се случва наистина или не. Примерно казвам на човека, когато е отпуснат, когато е в хипноза вече, че отива на една поляна, на тази поляна има един магически кладенец, като изпие една чаша от тази магическа вода, всякаква тревожност, всякакви негативни мисли ще изчезнат напълно. Така мозъка го възприема като реално и само, че изпива някакво хапче, което лекува всичко.
My personal opinion on hypnotherapy? Well, I can't really say if it's gonna have any effect in the long term, but did it get me relaxed? Oh yeah, it felt like waking up after a sweet dream. But it got me thinking, how often in our stressful daily life we just take our time shutting off the rest of the world? Either way, through hypnotherapy or something else, I really suggest that you get rid of all that stress. After all, it's up to you to decide where you lay your trust.